I'm thinking that I, it's maybe time I got a new tattoo. Nothing gets an audience of drunk people behind you like saying, let's get a tattoo, it's Friday night, man! Do you know why tattoo parlors don't open in the morning? Nobody wants a tattoo in the morning. Nobody gets up in the morning and goes, let's get a tattoo. It's more a kind of, I just had a great idea! No, man, no, this'll be awesome! And, do you know what I always think? See, when I... I do like tattoos, I do. I have one myself, it's right there. You can't see it, I'm wearing clothes. But, it's not cable. What I always think, I like tattoos, but when I see someone who has a tattoo of a spider's web on their neck, I think, was that the wisest choice? Nothing says, hey, I want to take you to meet Mom and Dad like a spider's web. But maybe that's what it's for. I don't want to meet your damn Mom and Dad. But then I'm thinking, well, there's other times in life where maybe, you know, well, you can always wear a turtleneck, of course, and then you're fine. But you can maybe see the web. The reason why I'm talking about it is because there's a lady here tonight and she's got tattoos there. Now, I don't normally look there on a lady. I don't. But she's got tattoos right there. And I said, what are they, pineapples? I said. And she thought I was talking about the tattoos. We'll be right back with the show. It'll be better than this.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by America's largest mobile-to-mobile calling family. Craig Ferguson.
Hey, look at you. Come on in. Have a lovely
week. Welcome to Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Late Late Show. I am your host, TV's Craig Ferguson. Thank you. All right. Thank you. Please. All right, come on. Please.
Quietly, you'll wake up Drew Carey. He's napping backstage. The Price is Right is shot right next to the studio right here. At this time of night as well. Because we're live and they got into the habit of doing The Price is Right during the night when Bob Barker was the host. Because, you know, of course, Bob can't go out in the daylight because of, you know, the whole... So... You didn't know, yeah? He's one of the good ones, though. He's a good vampire. Look at they made that movie for kids with good vampires in it. I'm like, what kind of crap is this? And all the teenage girls are like, oh, I love the vampires. They're so cute. And I go, they're vampires! But I digress. Does it count as digression if you don't start in the first place? It's a great day for America, everybody. And I'll tell you why. It's Friday! Yeah! Friday! You all right? That's right. That's not the kind of applause you get for any other day of the week. Try saying it's Monday, everybody's like, yeah. Sorry, my mouth went all kind of funny there. Don't worry, it's not your TV, it's my mouth. There's some kind of strange pixelation. Anyway, it's Friday, everybody, and... Yeah, all right. Now, here's some news. Arnold Schwarzenegger has taken time off as the governor of California to shoot a part in an upcoming movie. The movie's about a terrible disaster, and it's called Arnold Schwarzenegger is the Governor of California. Do you know, I hate to go off topic for a minute, but... actually, I don't. But you know, this whole not teaching, giving the schools any money, I think it may be a bad idea. That's what I think, you know.
Who am I? I'm not the Terminator. I don't know anything about running government. I'm not like, I'll be back. I'll be back to not educate your children unless they have money.
What else? Oh, yes, the E Network, my favourite network. Apart from CBS. No, E have announced they've ordered a series called Hot Girls in Scary Places. Don't they already have a show like that with Hugh Hefner and these three girls? And they... He's another one. Ever see him out during the day? No. All right. It's Friday, of course. It's a great day for Hollywood. It's the countdown to the Oscars. In less than 48 hours from now, the Motion Picture Academy will bestow its highest honor on a movie that you've never seen. Oh, that's right. You've seen them all. You lying bastard. The 81st Academy Awards is on Sunday, right here in LA. You could probably see the preparations beginning out there. Some people call it the gay Super Bowl. It's the Gaper Bowl. And people think the Academy Awards this year are going to have low ratings because the Best Picture nominees this year aren't, you know, they aren't making a lot of money. And I can see why, I've got to be honest. Benjamin Button, right? Brad Pitt, he's got his clothes on the whole time. No, I don't need to go. Slumdog Millionaire in this economy. Who likes millionaires? Nobody. There's a movie called The Reader. And then there's a movie called Milk, and everyone's lactose intolerant in LA. So right there, you know. But my money is on the movie Frost Nixon, because it's the only one I've seen. And there's a huge oversight this year that I think the movie Wall-E should have gotten a Best Picture nomination. Wall-E is an amazing story of a robotic creature dealing with an over-polluted Earth. It's based on the life of Al Gore, and very convincing. Now... You know, this year's Oscars are historic for many reasons. One of them is that Brangelina are both nominated. Or does that mean, is it right to say Brangelina are both nominated or Brangelina is nominated? I don't know. Anyway, Brad and Angie are nominated. And it's the first time, the only time it's ever happened before that a couple have both been nominated for Best Actor, Best Actress was in 1966, Richard Burton and Elizabeth Taylor. I love Elizabeth Taylor. That's a world-class beauty right there. Yeah. Do we have a picture of Elizabeth Taylor? There she is. If I find out who put that picture in there... Anyway, you wonder, though, if Brad and Angelina are both nominated, right? I wonder if there's tension around their house. Like, on Oscar morning, they're both crowded into the bathroom to get ready. That's right, Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie only have one bathroom. It's fake. And if you lose, like if you're Brad Pitt and you lose at the Oscars, how are you going to complain? Like, you're going to be gorgeous on the way to the Oscars, you're going to be gorgeous on the way back. What if Brad Pitt loses? You can't get in the car at the end of the night and go, I never get anything, I'm a loser. My life sucks. All I am is Brad Pitt. And I think the kids might get a little worried on Oscar night because, you know, they don't know it. Mom and Dad are both out of the house at the same time looking for someone named Oscar. They'll be thinking, this means a new kid. Hide your toys. I don't know this to be true. And the host this year is Hugh Jackman. I hope he shakes it up a little bit this year, because the Oscars have gotten boring. I miss the Oscars when they were fun and crazy, you know, like Robert Mitchum, you know, smoking reefer in the bathrooms and everything. There was that year there was a naked streaker. A guy ran across the stage. If that happens this year, Hugh Jackman will chase him down. He'll get right after him. That Wolverine will rip him a new one. He'll get right after him.
Gar!
Oscar night isn't just a ceremony, of course. There's the Barbara Walters annual Oscar special, which I deeply ignore. I love it. I want to see her interview Anne Hathaway this year because I want to see what she asked her.
So, Anne, which was your favourite movie you made? Is it The Devil Wears Prada or Wait Till Getting Married?
You better put her down to be a guest on the show, Barbara Walters, yeah. I like watching the show for the red carpet, you know. Who are you wearing? Who gives a rat's ass? Do you know what I think is the weirdest, though? When the women show off their dresses, like the movie actors show off their dresses and they're always doing this. What the hell is wrong with you? Oh, yes, do you like my dress? No, I can't see you. Just keep pointing your ass at me. Do you like the dress? Mm-hmm. I'm insane. All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back. I was just looking at a pigeon on the window ledge. I was really enjoying looking at that pigeon. And then the audience started cheering and the pigeon flew away. I think I must be tired. Oh, no, I'm high. Now, listen, with the financial crisis, the banks, of course, are all in the news. Here to talk about the bailouts is a bank CEO. Please welcome Dave Foley, everybody. Dave Foley. Please.
I'm sorry. I'm acknowledging the lone standing ovation I got.
Yeah.
Anyone can do it in a group. That takes courage.
Yeah. That's the danger of sitting down the front, of course. You get up to give someone a standing ovation, and everybody behind you is like, no.
Don't like him. Yeah. You've overestimated his appeal.
Yeah. I sometimes do that about... No, I don't. Now, Dave, of course, I know you as an actor.
Yes.
Very successful actor,
I might
add.
Good.
And, of course, you're Canadian.
Yes.
But I had no idea you were also the CEO of a bank.
Well, Craig, you know, I wanted to try something a little different. And now I will grant you, I know absolutely nothing about banking or stocks or the whole financial world.
It's a financial world.
That's how you say that.
That's how you say
God.
That.
Oh, that's funny. Basically, I guess, obviously, I don't know diddly squat about banking, which turns out to make me excellently qualified to run a bank.
Yeah, apparently. What do you say to the people who are concerned that banks have been careless with the bailout money?
Well, Craig, after I say, well, screw you, I like to say, I treat that money like it's my very own.
Mm-hmm.
You know, especially when I'm buying a new Mercedes or a mink-lined garbage can.
A mink-lined garbage can.
And before we start getting calls from PETA, I just want to point out they are live mink. So I'm just telling you, at my bank, we really don't waste a dime. I'm so sorry. Excuse me. Pardon me.
Hey! Hey, Dave, that's a $50 bill.
I know, Craig. It's terrible. I usually like to use hundreds. They're softer, you know, but...
this is what I'm talking about, Dave. There's billions of dollars that the banks can't account for. Now, where did that money go?
Well, Craig, I'll show you where $1 billion can go.
Okay.
How easily $1 billion can just disappear. Here, I have a chart with me.
Wow, you've got a chart?
I did. I brought a chart. Now,
right, okay.
Is that good? Do we have that over there?
Right.
Now,
see
you see...
Now,
There you go.
Yeah, but how does that chart show where the $1 billion went? I don't understand the chart. I can see the cat's face.
Craig, this chart is literally where $1 billion went.
What?
Yeah, this chart cost $1 billion. I mean, it's made out of pure gold. It's diamond encrusted.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It just, I find it makes my presentations really sort of pop.
Yeah, that, wow.
And that, look at that. That, yeah, those look, are,
that's
those
a $1 billion well spent. That doesn't look like it came from the 99 cent store at all.
No.
No. Wow, look at that thing. $1 billion, you say.
I know. Now, you see, you haven't left the high def yet, have you?
Yeah, no.
Oh, good.
No,
no,
no.
Right.
No, no, it's great.
Good, because I want to use this on Daily Show, too.
You see, now, the diamond encrusted thing, this is why people are angry. You've run the banks into the ground.
Yeah.
You know, doesn't seem to affect you at all. Well, seem quite laissez-faire. You're quite okay with it.
That just shows how callous you are, Craig
Ferguson. Really?
Yes. Do you realize that I recently had to, sell my beachfront home in the Hamptons? Craig, do you have any idea what it's like to be summer homeless?
I've never had a summer home.
Of course you haven't. You're an immigrant. But I'm sure in the course of time you've had to clean many of them. So you have some insight to the magnitude of my loss. Oh, I'm sorry, Craig. Do you mind?
Oh, yeah, no,
please. Oh, God, I have to take this one. Sorry.
Okay, fine, yeah.
Hello? Yeah, well, hey, look, you defaulted on that mortgage, all right? Yeah, you have to move out. No, I don't care if you have no place to go. That's your problem, bitch. Yeah, okay, bye, Mom.
How do you sleep at night?
Well, usually, Craig, I'm between two Brazilian hookers, and at about $1,500 per hour, we're not sleeping. We're doing something called the São Paulo squeeze. You know, first what Marisol does is she holds you down, and then what Carmen grabs your...
Hey, that's enough. Dave Foley, everybody. We'll be right back. That's enough. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big February the 20th show. My first guest this February the 20th stars in the new Lifetime movie America, which I have seen. It premieres on February the 20th. This is sensational. I've got to be honest with you. When I thought Lifetime movie, I thought, oh, here we go. So, but I watched it. It's really great. I mean, really great. I'm not just saying that. I'm not. It's really great. Don't you question me. Take a look for yourself. Look at this.
America, look at me. Whatever you don't deal with now, you're gonna have to deal with it later.
I don't care.
Well, you should care. You're 17 years old. When you turn 18, you age out of the system. You know what that means?
No.
It means no more services for you. The state's done. They raised you out. You're on the street, alone. You know what happens to those kids? Jail or homelessness. That's not a life for you.
Please welcome my friend Rosie O'Donnell, everybody.
Well, hello, Craig.
Hello, Ro.
Mr. Married Man.
I am married. I am married now. Are you still married or did they take it away?
I think they annulled us. Yeah.
How's Kelly with that? You all right?
Yeah, she's all right. She was more upset than I figured it would be annulled before it was then made legal and then made illegal.
Yeah, but...
I don't really know.
You know, when I heard that they were making gay marriages illegal, I thought, you know, where were you when I... during my last marriage, you know, for straight people.
Wanted that little retroactive. Whoa. I didn't really want to do it.
No, your marriage didn't count. Well, in
Woo!
That case,
we're
no
out,
alimony.
Honey. We're out of here. No, they just sent us a little paper that said, sorry, but you're annulled.
Right.
And Kelly was upset. She was crying, you know.
All right.
And I was like, honey, you know, you don't change things the next day. It's not like Rosa Parks sat in the front of the bus and the next day, all of racism ended in America.
Right.
You know, it's tiny steps at a time.
Little baby steps. And listen, congratulations on this this movie.
Thank you very much.
It actually is really good.
Which surprised you.
Well, look. No. In a... In kind of a way, because I thought, well, it's going to be a Lifetime movie. It's going to be very sappy.
Yeah.
It's
going to be, you thought there'd be a mass murderer or something.
I thought a guy would have a brain transplant and go nuts and wreck the joint.
And then have an affair with someone.
But it's a very powerful film.
It is. It's a wonderful, wonderful movie. I read the book in 2002, and it won some awards for the best teen novel. And it was written by a woman who is a social worker and based on her real life experience. And I bought it. And I wrote the script in like a week.
Wow.
Because I saw it as I was reading it. I saw the movie in the book. And so
it really is terrific. Congratulations. And this kid that you have, I was just blown away by this guy. I mean, this is a movie star you're looking at.
Sure is. He reminds me of Tupac Shakur.
Yeah.
Yeah, the way he looks and his presence.
Stillness.
And, yes.
And very kind of the gravitas about his performance. Very interesting.
And unbelievable abs, which were a bonus.
Yeah.
Because we didn't know that when we found him, actually. Larry and I, the other
Philip,
producer.
We should say his name, by the way.
Philip Johnson. Yes, yeah. Philip Johnson is his first movie ever. And Larry and I are the other producer. We were Thursday. We were about to shoot principal photography Monday. We had no lead kid. And that kid is really the crux of the movie. The meat of the movie is that
whole
character.
Movie's about him, yeah.
And we kept reading actors, but it didn't really work. And so we were at a little kind of diner restaurant in Detroit. There was only one other table in the restaurant. And Philip was there with his dad, two uncles and sisters. And I said to Larry, you see that kid right there? That's the kid who could play the lead role. You see how still he is and the way he looks and his cut? And Larry's like, what are you going to do? Go over there and ask him? And so I kept trying to catch the eye of somebody at the table. And finally, one of the uncles looked over and went, hey, aren't you Roseanne Barr? I'm like, Close enough. Let me tell you about my movie.
Nice. Yeah.
And I zoomed right over there and said, you know, John Goodman is a wonderful man, but now. And I asked him if he ever had acted, and he said no. And he's an engineering student. He's been recruited by Harvard and MIT. He's a really smart kid. And I said, well, if you want to, the final auditions are tomorrow, and we have to put some kids on tape. And just as a long shot, and Larry was like, that's ridiculous. And I'm like, you know what? It's 4th and 90. Let's just chuck the football, you know?
Yeah.
And he showed up, and boy, did he deliver.
Yeah, no kidding. Because Larry, I know, and Larry told me about this, and I was like, how good is this kid going to be?
Right.
Obviously, they were out of options, and they got some kid in a diner,
right,
which is what you did.
Pretty much,
but,
yes.
That's pretty lucky, though, to get that guy. I think he's really going to be a movie star.
I do, too. I think he definitely can have a career. And, you know, he said to me when he was reading that first time, you know, the whole crew was behind me and the producers and everyone, and he was right here. The cameras were looking at him, and we read the scene, and I thought, oh, my God, am I just feeling this because I'm desperate because it's the last? But that was unbelievable. I turned around, and everybody's mouth was open. They were, like, in shock, you know?
Yeah, that's much like the audience are most nights here when I go.
Well, you need to open up with puppets more often. I think that really grabs the crowd right at the beginning of the show.
Listen, you've done a daily show, and you know what happens? Stuff, you know, it's
Listen,
every day.
Had I thought of puppets, I'd probably still be on the air. I just skipped right over puppets, and I went to punting. I don't know how that happened.
Oh,
that's two football references in one show.
Yeah, no, what's going on?
I don't know. It's February 20th. The Super Bowl's over.
Yeah, I know. And may I just say, I know I've left it a little late.
Yeah.
But let me just say congratulations to the Steelers. Tell us, are you still doing the blog? Because the blog was crazy for a while.
Yeah, it got a little crazy. You know, when I first started, it was like 6 years ago. Nobody knew what a blog was. They were like, you know, what is that? It's like an online journal. I was trying to teach people. And then it got to be a little commonplace. And with MySpace and Facebook, everybody sort of had one. And everything that I would do that felt artistic and creative in the beginning was sort of, you know, edited and used on those entertainment shows at 7:30. And I was like, ugh, this isn't worth the hassle, you know. So now I'm sort of going to do it in a way just to sort of promote the charity and the philanthropic things that I'm doing. But no more of Rosie's inner angst at Rosie.com.
Yeah, I'd like to believe that. But I
you
think
don't we'll think?
Seeing, I think we'll be seeing plenty of Rosie's inner angst for years and years to come.
It's so tragic. Because just when I think I have it handled, something happens,
I tell you one thing that I did see that I haven't talked to you since is I saw the documentary you made about the cruise that you took with the kids, which I, again, watched with skepticism because I thought, I don't want to watch that. I was crying buckets the whole thing.
Yeah, that's a wonderful film.
It was an amazing film, all these different parents. So it was gay parents with their kids, right?
That's right,
it was pretty much it. And the God, wow.
Sheila Nevins at HBO, who's a friend of mine, an amazing filmmaker. She's won Oscars and Emmys, and she heads all the documentaries there at HBO. I've been lucky to work with her three times, and that was the second one we did. We have another one coming out about kids and self-empowerment, and that's coming out this August.
It's all about the kids with you. And how many do you have now, like 16 or something?
I've got four. But yeah. I would like to have more, but Kelly's not so up on that.
Right.
But she said, you will be the single mother of five. Just know that. It's your decision, honey, yeah, but think long and hard.
And are you still at the arts and crafts? Are you still doing, what are you doing
yes.
now?
Yes, now I have a new thing, and I brought a gift for everyone. There
oh,
is,
hello.
Now you know the Kid Robot guy, right?
I love the Kid Robot thing.
Okay.
Yes, this thing.
Okay, Kid Robot is this amazing toy company that does unique one-of-a-kind robots, and they have one sort of brand, one line called the Munnies. And they come like this in different sizes and different colors, pink, blue, and white, and you draw on them yourself. And someone gave me a few.
Can I draw on one now?
Go right ahead.
Yeah, all right.
Somebody gave me a few for Christmas, and I became obsessed, Craig.
Right.
Such shock that I would become obsessed with something.
Yeah. Because you don't have any inner angst left. It's
you're
amazing
down with OCD?
That you have.
Yeah, yeah, you know me. You got some OCD. That's me. But, all right, so here we go. This is what I was doing in your green room while I was waiting.
Wow.
But you, I know, I get like, it's unbelievably fun. This box is only $10. It comes with a marker, comes with a little accessory, and you and your kid will spend 2-3 hours talking, each doing one. It's an amazing toy.
You know what I just did right there when you were talking?
What's that?
I made David Letterman.
Let me see. Well, now that is good. You sign that for me. You sign that bottom foot. Yeah. There you go. I'm taking that for my charity event. I'm selling it. David Letterman. Maybe I can do a puppet show with them. Hello, how are you?
Do you know what's amazing? Actually, not a lot of people know this. This is actual size. Dave is very, very small.
Yeah, I do know that. Yeah.
Very, very small.
He lives
man.
In a tiny little people Fisher Price house. You know?
Which tells you how small Paul Schaefer must
oh,
be.
Oh, you can't
because,
even
yeah.
see him.
Yeah. No. Not with the unaided microscope.
No, they have a zoom lens on all those cameras. They get right into teeny little Paul.
Robbie Paul.
Pick me up, Dave. Pick me up.
Hey, yours doesn't have a face.
Not yet, because I do one color at a time, and then I add the face last, because I don't like it to smudge.
Well, you've got a much more complex style than me.
I know. You're just sort of two circles, a dot, and you're out. That's how my little kids do them. You know, they're really fun to do. I try to limit my kid to do one a day, which, you know, sounds exorbitant and totally over the top. But it's a great toy, and our kids go to a school where you're not allowed to watch TV. So these come in very, very handy if your kids go to a no-school TV thing.
Yeah.
But my kids do them all the time, and it's a really wonderful, wonderful invention. I went and met the guy, and I just told him how much I love him. I said, I'm doing some talk shows to promote this movie. Would you give me them for the whole audience of every show?
And they all get them?
They said yes! Yeah. So you get them!
We have to take a break. We'll come back. Can you stay around?
Yeah.
Rosie and Donna, we'll be right back.
Yeah, we'll be right back.
Welcome back. I'm here with the lovely Rosie O'Donnell. Rosie, I haven't watched The View since you left. Do you keep in touch with the ladies there?
Joy, I could keep in touch with. I've known right. Joy for probably 20 years. I started doing stand-up together with her back when I was like 18 years old. And I've known her for a long time. She's a wonderful, funny
Seems
lady.
Very nice. She's always very nice to me when
yeah.
I'm there. Very nice woman.
Stand-up comics, you know how they all kind of have the same...
drinking problems?
Yes.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, I'm off the sauce.
Are you really?
I'm off honey, yes.
Oh,
I did
really?
It when I was in my 20s. I didn't drink for 8 years.
Right.
And then sometime around 30, I was like, well, give me a Michelob, and that was that. And so, seriously, my son is 13, and we're going to the Galapagos. And he said to me, are you going to come with us? Because you don't like to go on trips. And I'll go, no, I'm going to come. He goes, I know how to get you to come. I'll take away your beer.
Whoa.
Now, I said to him, so you think if you took away my beer? That he goes, I think you'd do anything if I took away your beer.
Wow.
So I said, you know what, honey? When I was 20s, I didn't drink at all. And he goes, well, maybe you should do that again. I said, well, what if I can't? He goes, you know, they have this club. And I think it's called a drunk club. And you go to it, and you have to be drunk. So I don't know if they'd let you in, but
no,
maybe...
No, they'd let you in.
That's what I said. They'd let me in. Mommy's been to that club. And
yeah.
So that...
Yeah, mommy's friend is still in that club.
Yes, well... So it's an interesting thing, as I'm sure you know. But
yeah, well, I do, only too well. But the Galapagos, that's exciting. They've got the giant tortoises there.
They certainly do. Yeah. And you're not allowed to touch anything. How well am I going to do there?
No, not well at
all. I'm going to pick up a baby something and go, come to mommy, and then there's going to be sirens, and I'll be in a feud. It'll be on E.T., you know. Rosie and the tortoises. You know.
They don't...
The tortoise will have a toupee, you know. She's fat. I always thought she was fat. I'm back in my shell, you know.
He does look a bit like a tortoise,
kind
I suppose.
Don't mention his name. He's like Lord Voldemort, he who shan't be named.
All right.
Okay.
All right, fair enough. But that's it. I've actually seen giant tortoises.
Where?
But in the Seychelles, which is islands off the east coast of Africa.
Really? Yeah, is that anywhere near the Galapagos?
No, it's nowhere. No, I think the giant tortoises were on vacation or something.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
They were there, and they have giant tortoises there, and I saw them mating.
Are you kidding?
I saw giant tortoise porn.
And now, knowing how slow they move, how long did you watch?
They were, you know, it was a while.
I can imagine a giant tortoise screw takes a long time.
It does. And it has. It has this very, it sounds like very slow clacking as the two shells clack against each other. That's absolutely true.
Wow, I hope I get to see that.
Well, you know.
I'll bring my flip video camera and just get the whole thing on. Say, put it up on my blog, my inner angst about turtle sex, but yeah.
No, don't confuse them with turtles. They're not turtles.
They're not?
No, they're not aquatic.
At all?
Not at all. They stay in the dry.
They're land animals.
Land animals. All they're much like horses, except not. But they do. They do.
I've seen horses in rivers and streams.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Just so you know.
Yeah, but they're not considered an aquatic animal.
Not
usually. No one would say, look, I live in an island. If only I had a horse to escape.
Yeah.
That's not.
Right. A few years ago, maybe you and I would have. But I don't know. The first few months are the worst.
Oh, I remember it well.
Ooh, yeah.
I screamed for a solid 6 months, I think. I was like,
really?
Ah!
I know. And the best part's when you go out with your friends who, of course, are still drinking, and you know how much they drink because you used to do it with them.
Yeah, no.
So, you know, and you're trying not to appear like the boring sober one.
I still go and hang out with guys I used to drink with in Glasgow back in the day when I go back home. But what happens is I wait until they start telling me everything twice and I go home.
That's what I know. Exactly. Just the distance. Sometimes they're so drunk they don't notice you're gone. They know that. I have those friends.
They don't notice I've been gone for 14 years.
Where you been, Craig?
Oh, Craig, hello. Have you got a new shirt on? No, I've been in America for 14 years. Aye, whatever. Come on in. No, it's true.
Yeah.
Do you ever go to Ireland, Donal?
Yes. After my mother died, my father took all of his five young children to Belfast. It was 1973.
What a time to be
Wasn't that
Belfast?
A great idea? I'm not sure that Oprah Winfrey recommends that for childhood grief.
No.
You know, take your kids to a war zone.
Yeah.
I went there when I was a young kid, like 11 years old, for a whole summer once. But I've been back once as an adult, and I'd like to go again. I can't deal with the rain. It rains a lot there. And then I was there one summer, and it was literally 68 degrees. And people were like, oh, my Lord, I can't believe how hot it is. I'll be going for a wee swim, you giantess Rose. I'm with the parka in the Volkswagen. Like, They have a different kind of sense. And I don't know.
You're in New York. It's cold there.
I hate it. It's horrible, the winter. I'm getting to be one of those people who I want to stay in Florida from Christmas until spring. I just want it, like, till middle March.
Do you know what I like about Florida is they have the giant drugstores where you can get all sorts of different types of cortisone.
Really?
You can
get hydrocortisone?
Any cortisone.
5% cortisone?
Any cortisone you want.
Mm.
And what happens is if you feel even the slightest itch in your body...
Anywhere.
They can cure it.
Now, I didn't know that there was, like, a cortisone shortage in other cities. Is there...
It's all in Florida. No other city can get it.
I didn't know that.
People in the north, in Chicago and Detroit, are itching like crazy.
I'm going to set up a new eBay business. Cortisone for you. Love, Rosie. Sober, nothing to do. Send.
I don't know if you should. I think it's illegal to transport cortisone over state lines.
Really?
Yeah. It's a controlled substance.
Only in Miami.
No. And you know what I also like about Florida?
What's that?
That I'm the kid.
You are.
When I
Without
get there, I'm like,
doubt.
I'm the... They're like, who rat young? And I'm like, hey!
Well, you'll have to come visit me because I have a house there that you can't imagine. When I was first starting out in this business and I did that baseball movie with Madonna, I went and stayed at her house. And I, and I used to go around in my rented car around Star Island and I'd drive around this island and I'd say, gosh, if I ever make it, I'm going to buy a house on this island. And so when my show was on, I talked to my banker guy. I said, listen, do I have enough money to buy a house there? He goes, you could buy any house you want there. Now, I've owned it probably for 12 years. Every time I drive in, I go, holy crap, I can't believe this is my house.
That's fantastic.
Every time
that
I drive
fantastic.
In.
That is fantastic. You hang on to that and you'll be all right.
I sure will. All right. And I'll look for tortoises screwing.
Yes,
okay. Good.
Would you not want to run it? We'll be right back.
Thank you, Noel.
My next guests are rapping brothers. They're here performing Bang Bang from their debut album, Remind Me in 3 Days. Please welcome. Please welcome the Knux, everybody, the Knux.
Everybody, put your hands together. We're having a wonderful time.
Come on! Yeah! When the drum goes bang, 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 who's gonna know the one? No, nobody knows. When the drum goes bang, 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 who's gonna know the one? No, nobody knows the one.
Taking it back to 94, my brothers was gonna define their soul. Crack their head, that bastard up, and baby,
that's the one full of that blood.
Pluck the feathers up off a duck, who stuck like Chuck, you're carrying a batter. Everyone knows I'm messing with the hood. Pick you a teacher from out there.
No.
I'm full of that early pop and silly, but brothers were doing the choppers.
And I was a dancing B-boy.
Who was known as the slugger, the
E-boy.
And jacking the cars, back in the broad statistics to flip the script. I don't want to like a hypocrite, but mama raised me for greatness. Who be broke is what, and hope is luck. Anyone as I find the gate, this. That animal house getting out like taking food from an animal's mouth. Row, row, like a dungeon dragon, taking it back to the cannibal.
When the gum goes bang, bang.
You couldn't imagine beautiful women so real with him. Your brothers are having flip bridge and a grab and a change of lane like Benjamin M. They're 10 to 12, they're thinking it's cool. Something I'm moving, they ain't in the mood. Don't get them bit, but they're innocent. Cause innocent, they feel me shoot. What if mama said? What if mama said?
Nobody knows.
Said nobody cares.
You claim your heart, come close with the walls, come mess with them.
Won't nobody down.
Your job, yeah.
You're Mo Jocka.
I put that mama on you like
Red and Black.
Cause I think they say the same thing you. Cause they got me for their dog in
the tune. When the drum goes bang, 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 who's gonna know?
Outside,
I think you know what we learned on the show tonight. And if you don't, neither do I. Good night, everybody. Good night.